Today we have decided to revisit the classics, favorites, films that in a sense introduced us to documentary and film school. The first two films are Nightmare and Song of Ceylon, and these are really important landmark films because they were made in the 30s in England, and this is a time when the documentary movement in a sense is officially called the documentary movement, because Grierson, who set up the film producing unit that uses actuality, he coined the word a document of reality when he was reviewing a film, not Nanook of the North, but the other one called, I forget the other one after Nanook of the North. But he coined the term when he was reviewing the film, that this is a document of reality. And that's how the term documentary came about. The British film movement that used actuality, that was another word coined by them, they were very influenced by the political and the propagandist potential of the documentary medium, and were very into that genre of, Grierson actually said, you know, we should see ourselves as priests on the pulpit who are there to transform society. So they had a very political agenda, and they began looking at stories of the common folk. And that's how these two films were commissioned, actually. Both are by Basil Wright. The first one, Nightmare, is by Basil Wright and another filmmaker. Interesting thing about this film is that W.H. Auden was an assistant on this film. And he obviously already had established himself as a poet. And at some point in time, the filmmakers felt that the film had managed to, it was commissioned by the postal department, had managed to get that system of various people working together to get the letters, but were not able to evoke the spirit of the people who wrote and received the letters. And that's how they asked the assistant, Auden, to write some text, and it's become the most celebrated part of the film. The sound design is again very, very extraordinary. The ideas of sound design that develop in Nightmare become even more elaborate and very, very complex by the time Basil Wright makes a film called Song of Ceylon, which was actually commissioned by a colonial institution in Ceylon, by the tea board there. But Basil Wright manages to make a film that critiques a lot of things, again, using very, very complicated notion of montage and sound design. So both these films are extraordinary for music, the use of sound design, and the use of polemics through montage. The last film, in a sense, we included in the package because it's a very different kind of a landmark film from a very different point in time. It's a film produced by Films Division. We have screened it at FD Zone when we started off. But it's again an important film to see how the experimental mode was used in documentary form within Films Division. So Arrival is, I don't think it needs an introduction. It's made by Manikol. He does some extraordinary things in the film. And we just thought three classics together would be a nice way to get people to come on a Diwali weekend. So we won't be stopping in between the films, but after the film, if people are up for a conversation, we can surely have that. Thanks.
Here's a departure message for the Down Postal.
Hi, Neil.
Okay.
Crew control, Houston Delia. 157 Postal, left at 8:30. Class 6 engine, 340 tons, 12 vehicles.
8:30 p.m. Weekdays and Sundays. The Down Postal special leaves Houston for Glasgow, Edinburgh, and Aberdeen. The postal special is a fast express, but it carries no passengers. it is manned by 40 post office workers. 500,000 letters are sorted, picked up or dropped at full speed during the night, or carried on for the morning delivery in Scotland. Attention, Beat. Attention, Beat, you see. Can you take postal special? Can you take postal special? Can you take postal special?
I'm here.